I'm passionate about understanding developmental biology, partly because it's an amazing system to understand, but also because it gives us insight into developmental defects that then affect adult humans. And one good example of that is when the backbone doesn't form properly. This is a condition called congenital scoliosis, and its origins come from these early developmental processes in the embryo. So we don't study that problem in humans. We study that problem in a tropical aquarium fish called the zebrafish. And zebrafish are a great model system because when the mothers drop their eggs, they fall down to the bottom of the tank, and we can scoop them up, put them on the microscope, and because they're nearly completely transparent, we can see all the cells moving around, and we can see them swapping signals, making shapes. I got into science in a kind of circular way, a roundabout way. I wanted to be a professional cyclist when I was young, and I even rode for a Dutch team as a teenager. And I injured my knee, and when I came back home to try and heal my knee, my mum said, "No way you're staying at my house unless you pay rent." But she's a clever person, and she said, "Although if you went to university, you could stay here for free." So I jumped at the chance. And actually, that's when I first encountered things like the genetic code and physiological oscillations, and my mind was blown. And so from that point onwards, although I never lost my love of cycling, I developed a new passion for biology and for patterns. You're probably familiar with your circadian clock, which regulates your daily rhythms, waking and sleeping and eating. When that clock comes out of phase with the daylight, that's when you get jet lag. So in the embryo, there's another clock called the segmentation clock, and its rhythm determines how the backbone gets formed. And correspondingly, when its rhythm comes out of whack, then the backbone doesn't form properly, and that's called congenital scoliosis. Each of the cells in the tail of the embryo is oscillating, just like a clock, and they exchange information with each other so that they all oscillate at the same time. And it's this pulse of information that the cells generate that gives the information for each of the successive backbones that forms in the first day of life. If this segmentation clock is not working properly, then the result is that the fish or the human or the mouse or whatever vertebrate you're thinking about, it can't make its backbone properly. The research in the lab at the moment is focused on the basic mechanisms of how this segmentation clock works and how it patterns the fish embryo. What we hope in the long term is from studying that, we'll be able to learn how to fix those defects, these genetic defects, and maybe come up with a cure for human scoliosis.